like many other legendary Ashanti heroes and heroines, had to make some sacrifices to save the Ashanti nation. These included the loss of his tomb and position as a champion. He came as a bombshell on the fateful day of 12 January 1861, when Ashanti Hill 247 Simon Pemper II announced to the world that Balfour, who was languishing in political prison, had been destroyed and his Dragoon Pierre Chamis to abolish. Many were those who wondered how such a big blow could be dealt someone who had all his life fought to maintain the dignity and sustenance of the golden stool of Ashanti. But Otunfuo Ashanti knew that Balfour would save the golden stool at all costs. This was at a time when Nkrumah had declared that chiefs would, and I'll quote, run away and leave their sandals behind, unquote. And when the CPP government had threatened to break up Ashanti mine. So if this stealing Balfour was a decision that would avoid such a confrontation to save Ashanti mine, then why not? The good news was that the Butuakar Appear Champions School was reinstated, and Balfour Mutombo was reinstalled as an occupant of the school after the going through the Nkrumah regime in February 1961.